Hello, this is Tom the tour guide, a local witch here in Salem, Massachusetts, and we are at the Salem Witch Trials Memorial. This was dedicated to the victims of the Salem Witch Trials in 1992, which was the 300th anniversary. This is a very important site for two specific reasons. The first is that nobody knows where any of the bodies of these victims ended up. There are legends and there are rumors that some of the bodies were recovered by family members, but those are just legends. And there's also a bit of a legend where they discovered a body of someone and they assumed it was one of the victims and gave it a proper burial. And the fact is that there's not too much evidence to support that. It is kind of just a guess. Now, the bigger and more important reason that this memorial is so important is because, contrary to what you may have heard in the news recently, nobody actually knows where Gallows Hill was. Now, there has been some news articles circulating around recently where people talk about a team of researchers that discovered Gallows Hill. Usually the headlines say something like they discovered it. But the fact is that all of the historical information that they used to base that discovery on is information that's been out there for a long time. In fact, many of us historians have already guessed that that was the most probable site of the witch trials. The important thing is, though, in order to be historically accurate, we do have to say that it is a probable explanation. It's not even a testable hypothesis at this point, regardless of what you may have heard. Nobody knows where it is. The research that they have is based on things that are from around the early 1900s. In fact, there have been other people that have gone up there and said that this was the site. A few decades ago, Laurie Cabot, for instance, went there and said that it felt like the right site. I've been up there multiple times myself throughout the past decade, and the truth is that it is just kind of in the backyards of some neighborhood. It's behind Walgreens, it's kind of dirty and gross. The other thing is, we have to assume that area being so heavily industrialized in the 1800s, they probably would have used dynamite on a lot of the rocks around there in order to clear the way for train tracks. So it's probably safe to assume that Gallows Hill doesn't look at all like it would have looked like a long time ago. And in fact, the scientific evidence that this new group of researchers has done up there to test the ground for magnetic resonance didn't turn up anything.